I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way.
Hey, welcome back to the Maple Minute. This Thursday, January 18th, 2024. I'm Pastor Bill. Today we're talking about grapes. And you'll understand in just a minute what I mean by that. Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 and 23 says, but the fruit of the Spirit is, and that doesn't seem to be right, but we'll get back to that in a minute. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, or you could say long-suffering. Some of the other translations say that. Kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. You know, when you first looked at that, and I stopped and hesitated too, at first glance, the sentence structure appears to possess a grammar or grammatical error. When he said the fruit of the Spirit is, shouldn't that be plural if it's fruit are, right? But the Apostle Paul is absolutely correct here. You see, the ninefold fruit of the Spirit is the outward evidence of the presence of the one living within us. The fruit of the Spirit is beyond our natural ability to produce, for it is inwrought, and that's sort of it's an inward working, but it is outworked by the Holy Spirit within us. It's He who's the author of these attributes and the source from which they flow. See, the fruit of the Spirit is what we are, and it is wrought or made within us by whose we are, that is the Holy Spirit, not by anything we do in our own strength. And that's so important we understand that. You cannot produce it yourself. You have the Holy Spirit in you. So that indwelling that we've been spending so much time talking about is so important. The fruit of the Spirit is produced by the Spirit-controlled life, and it manifests itself in three basic areas that I see here in this ninefold fruit. You could divide it into three areas, three subjects each. First, when God's Spirit is ruling and reigning on the throne of your heart, it's expressed through your countenance. That is, your personal relationship with God, the expression of which is love, joy, and peace, right? When we do have love, joy, and our peace in our life, it shows on our face. It shows on our outward countenance. Now, it doesn't always show a smile. It doesn't mean you have to always have a smile on your face, but there's always a glow that is noticeable. There's something different. You could say it that way. I think that's how it's been explained before. The second is it is visible, the Spirit-controlled life, or the fruit of the Spirit is visible in your conduct, is what he teaches here. That is, your relationship with other people, the outward expression of which is forbearance, or I said a lot of times, long-suffering, kindness, and goodness. And those should be evident in our life, how we do things. Are we kind? Do we have long-suffering towards insufferable people? I guess that's how I say it. And then finally, the third area, it is evidenced by your character. Who you are in relationship with yourself, the expression of which we would find in the last three words, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Those are character quality traits that really are exhibited when the Spirit is in control. So going forward, we must each ask ourselves this one question. If my life is filled with, is my life filled with the Spirit's fruit? Do I see the ninefold fruit of the Spirit coming out in my conduct, my countenance, and my character? That's the question. And we'll get into this a little bit more in each episode to follow. Today, though, I gave you the word grapes. Today, when you eat a grape from a cluster of grapes, or any piece of fruit, because this is the winter and you may not be a lot of fruit, but any kind of fruit, let it be a reminder that it was produced by the vine and it did nothing in and of itself to present you with such a treat. The fruit doesn't grow itself. It's the vine that produces it. And the fruit of the Spirit is produced in you because of whose you are and not really what you do, but what you allow the Spirit to do in your life. So hopefully you'll be growing and learning to let the Spirit control you and flow through you. So let's talk about some questions as we finish it up today. Number one, what outward evidences have you seen on a person you regard as Christ-like? Talk about the outward now. And how does the outward expression affect other people? Number two, what would the conduct of a Spirit-controlled person look like versus a religious person? And are they the same? Maybe that's something I should have asked. Is there a difference? and why? And then last of all, how do you see Jesus model the character of a spirit-controlled person in his earthly ministry? These are great questions to think about, and hopefully as you move forward in your lives, you'll be able to embrace these as you talk about them and grow towards Christ. So if there's something we can do for you here at Maple Springs, please reach out to us and contact us. As always, we have a mission to lead people into a growing relationship with Jesus Christ, and that's what we're all about. So if you don't know Jesus, we want to introduce him to you. But if you do, we'd like to help you get to be more solid in your journey with him. Everybody needs partners along the road. Fellowship is one of the activities of the church. And so we want to help you as we move forward in our relationship with Jesus Christ, always growing and ever learning. So until next time, this has been the Maple Minute. All the way, I'm gonna praise Jesus' name, 'cause his love goes on forever. His love reaches to the highest mountain. His love